Hello students, today we are going to see chapter number 2, that is indicator of growth and development of standard 12 commerce subject economics. So this is the second part of the chapter number 2. First part is linked in the description. In that first part we have understood the meaning of economic growth, and again we have seen the definition of that and limitation. So economic growth is related to developed country, and development is a developing country, as we have seen yesterday. So today we are going to see the economic development, why there is a need of economic development, and why developing country trying to increase their development. And again here we are going to see definition of the economic development, characteristic as well as limitation of economic development. Let's see with the meaning of economic development. Let's see the meaning of economic development. So here, economic development is a process which is continuous. So economic development is a continuous process to achieve economic well-being. So here, the reason for the continuous process is to achieve the economic well-being. So here the welfare of the people is very important. Hence economic development has very wide meaning. So here we have seen the meaning of economic growth, where we have seen that there is an increase in national income and a real per capita income. That was the reason for the economic growth. But here with increasing income, there is a well-being of the people is also connected here. So it is a wide meaning, includes economic growth. So here economic growth is included because there is a need of increase in real national income as well as real per capita income. But with the increase of real national income and real per capita income, there should be a increase in the well-being of the people. There should be a structural change in the society, and psychological change of the people is also needed in economic development. So economic development is a wide meaning and economic growth is a narrow meaning. So here include economic growth, economic welfare and economic progress. So here in economic development there are the three things that is included. Very first is economic growth, second one is economic welfare, and third one is economic progress. So if three of them are included, that becomes economic development. So here in economic development there is an increase in real national income and real per capita income, but it is not just quantitative. So here we are not just talking about only real national income and real per capita income, but here we are also talking about the well-being of the people, lifestyle of the people of the country. So it is not only quantitative change, but it is also qualitative change. So quality of the society must be increased. So people must get healthier food, nutrient food. Again, people must get pure drinking water and the other facility like hospital, education, etc. So here we are not just talking about the quantity, but we are talking about the quality of the lifestyle of the people. So that's why it is called multi-dimensional process, because here we are not just talking about the quantity of the country, but we are also talking about the quality of the people of the country. So here it is economic development is called multi-dimensional process. During the process of the economic development, social structure of the society, economy is changed. So here society is getting changed, then psychology is getting changed. So social structure of the society is getting changed. Again, the structure of the national income also undergoes change. So here as we know, any country is having national income that is from three sectors, that is agriculture sector, then there is an industrial sector and service sector. getting the development, that the national income of that must be the part of the sum must be from the agriculture sector, that must be reduced. The part of the agriculture sector of the national income must be reduced, and that comes from the industrial as well as service sector. So that means the national income, structure of the national income is changing. The contribution of agriculture, percentage of total income must be decreased, and industry and service sector must be increased. So here, when total of the national income is there, the percentage of agriculture sector must be decreased in that national income, and the percentage of the other two sectors, that is industrial sector as well as the service sector, that must be increased. So that change can be seen during the economic development. Here again we discuss on employee in agriculture sector, get employment in other sectors. So here, as we know that in a developing country there is a hidden unemployment in the agriculture sector. Because of the joint family, the many people, they are working in a agriculture sector, but the some people they are non-productive. That means if we are going to reduce them from that agriculture sector, they are not the production will not decrease. So that means they are discussed or hidden unemployed. So here that unemployed people during the development will get the employment in other sector, the other two sector, that is an industrial sector in a service and in a service. The other thing is going to change, that is the modern technology is being implemented, due to which time and money is saved. So here during employment there is a change in a technology of the all three sector, that is agriculture sector also, people they are changing the technology, and with the help of modern technology, modern seeds and modern machine, the people they are now cultivating the land. So because of that, their time and money both are going to be saved. And between the development, poverty and unemployment and inequality fall due to systematic change in the economy. So here during the development there is a decrease of poverty as well as unemployment, because the unemployed people they are getting job or employment in a other sector, and the unemployment and poverty both is reducing. Again inequality also reduced due to the systematic change. So this is the meaning of economic development. Now let's see the definition of economic development. You may note down this in your notebook. Now let's see the definition of economic development. So here very first definition of economic development is that economic development is multi-dimensional process. As we have seen in the meaning of the economic development, that the economic development is not only quantitative change, but it is also qualitative change. And due to the economic development, during the process of economic development, there is a structural change where we can see that the income of agriculture sector reduced in the national income, and other two sector, that is industrial sector as well as service sector, the part of that is increased in the real national income. So here we can see that during the process of economic development there is a multi-dimensional process has been done in the economy. So that's why it is called multi-dimensional process, and this definition is given by the Michael Todak. So that is the second definition of economic development. Is economic development is such a process in which there is no increase in the population living the below poverty line. So here there are some people who is living below poverty line, but that population is not increasing due to the economic development. So people, those we are living below poverty line, that is not going to be increased in the economy. The distribution of income does not increase in economy. So here, due to the economic development, the distribution of income has been in an equality form. So inequality of the distribution of income is reduced due to the economic development. And there is a continuous rise in a real per capita income as well as the national income of the country. So there is an increase, continuous increase, not for a short period of time but for a long period of time. There is an increase in a real national income as well as real per capita income of the country. So here, this is the definition which is given by the G.M. Mayer. So that is, now let's see the third definition. Then it is, economic development is a process in which increase the factor of production and create change in the technique of production. So here we have already seen in the meaning that due to the economic development, modern technology has been introduced, and with that help money and time is changed. So here again the same thing is given, that the technique of the production is changed, and because of that money and time both is going to be saved of the economy, and due to which per capita income continuously increases as there is a new technology has been introduced for the production. So with that per capita income is also continuously increased, and the standard of living of the people is also continuously rises, irrespective of whether population remain constant or increased. So here there is no need to check that the population is increasing or not increasing. Even if the population is increasing, but the standard of living of the people of the country is continuously rises due to the economic development, and there is no need to check that the population is increasing or constant, whatever the situation, but the standard living of the people is continuously rises. So these are the definition of economic development. You may note down this in your notebook. Then we are going to see the characteristic of economic development. Now let's see the characteristic of economic development. So here, in the very first characteristic of economic development is, it is a continuous process. So here in the economy, the development is a continuous process. It is not like that once it is finished then it is not going to start again. So the economic development is a process which is going to continuous in the economy. So here, economic development is slow but a strong process in a predetermined order and direction. So here it is slow but a strong process, and it is in the direction of predetermined. It is already determined before. So in that direction. In any country, development process is easy to start but difficult to maintain. So here, once development process is start, it is very difficult to maintain it. This process is usually fast initially, but slow down later on, that is over a time. So here, this process, once initially, it is very fast, but when after some period of time, it is slow down, and slowly, slowly, it is continuing the process. So that is the very first characteristic of economic development. Now let's see the second one. That is the quantitative and qualitative change take place. So here we already seen that economic growth is a quantitative process. But here, economic development is a quantitative as well as qualitative. So here in economic development, output increases which is quantitative. And due to research, process. So here we already seen that the economic growth is a quantitative process because it is in that the four factor of production increases and because of that output increases. When the output increases in the economy, with that the national income and per capita income also increases. So that is called quantitative change. But here, with the increment of production, there is a research, and because of research, there is a quality of the product is also increases. So that is called qualitative process. So economic development is quantitative as well as qualitative, quantitative and qualitative process. So that is. The third characteristic is change in demand. So here, in the initially, when the income of the people increased, with that, the people asking for the basic necessity. Once their basic necessity is completed, they are asking for comfort and luxury goods. So here, the demand of the people is changing due to the economic development. So here, the rise in the income of the people due to development, which changes their taste. In the stage of development, demand of basic or primary goods rise, but subsequently there is a rise in the demand for comfort and luxurious goods. So here, because the income is increasing, with the increased income, people they are asking for the luxury and comfort goods. So the demand of the goods is changing. So the fourth one is that labor become more dynamic. So we hear with the development, education of the people also increase, which make them more dynamic. So development leads to increase in education of labor, which makes them more dynamic. So there is. The fifth one is the increased capital formation. So here, development leads to increase in demand for the different commodities. New enterprise come forward due to which rate of investment and capital formation increases. So here, because the new type of goods is in the demand, so with that new entrepreneur they are entering in the economy, and with that the capital structure of the economy also changes. So the change in the technology. So there is a shift in dependent from fire and water based technology to coal and iron based technology, which result into faster development. So here there is a change in the technology. So with the change of technology, the development become more faster. So then the last characteristic of economic development is after a particular stage, development becomes self-motivating. So here, once development has started and after a particular time period, there is no need to motivate or there is no need of push for the economic development. It becomes self-motivating. So that is. Students, you may note down this, then we are going to see the limitation of economic development. Let's see the limitation of concept of economic development. So here, very first limitation of economic development is economic development indicates the process of nation. It shows the economic scenario, but in real sense, it cannot discuss the human development. So with the help of economic development, we cannot see the real development, that is the development of the human. We can just see the economic development. It cannot become the index of human progress. So economic development is the index of only economic of the country, but it cannot show the progress of the human. So here we cannot measure the human progress with the help of economic development. Now let's see the second limitation. The second limitation is economic development cannot be measured as economic growth. It is
very difficult to measure the economic development. Economic development includes those changes that have happened in the society. It is very difficult to derive a measurement for that. So here in the economic development, we have already discussed that economic development means economic growth plus welfare of the society. So here that welfare of the society we cannot measure in any measurement. So here it is a qualitative change. So we cannot measure it. Hence, we cannot find out exact development of the society. So that was the second limitation of the economic development. The third one is it. When economic development takes place, the standard of living of people improve. Though economic development is taking place in India today, there is not much improvement in the standard of living of people. Therefore, we cannot say economic development means improvement in the standard of living. So here, let's talk about the India. So in the Indian society, we can see that there is economic development, but we cannot see those changes in a standard of living of the people. So here, from economic development, we cannot consider that the standard of living of the people can be improved with the help of the economic development. So this is the limitation of economic development. Student, you may note down this in your notebook. Thank you for watching this video. In our next video, we are going to see the difference between economic growth and economic development.